Excellent. Okay, so I'm going to explain to you a little bit about the journey of art. And basically, the movement. Okay? So the first part is that you go to the front of your mat, like this. And the feet are together. Just like so. Stand, nice and steady. And you open up the arms.
Inhale. Push right up. Just like so. Then you lean back just a little. Just a little. And then you bring your hands down in front of the solar plexus.
Can you hear me okay? Is that alright?
Should I speak up?
Let me start again.
Sorry.
Take one.
Just because of the traffic, I think.
Oh yeah.
The noise of that.
You can hear it, yeah?
I think so, yeah.
That's terrible, isn't it? Alright, let me begin. So, I'm going to explain to you a little bit about the journey of Ra. Stand at the front of your mat. Feet are close together. And then you inhale like this.
Stretching up. Slight bend.
Bring the hands in front of the solar plexus. Just like so. Push into the solar plexus with the palms. Now you're balancing. You're balancing your energy, masculine and feminine. It's a small meditation that you're doing here. So basically you're meditating on confidence, consistency, and courage, just like the sun. Then you inhale,
back. Hands through the ball. We exhale.
The hands convert into a pyramid shape. So you make a pyramid shape and you're coming all the way down, drawing an elliptical line with the hands. Now, generally you'll press down into the mat, like so. If you can only go as far as your legs, that's okay. You go as far as the legs. If you can reach down to the ankles, that's fine too. So you can hold that position. But as long as you're stretching the hamstrings, you find that you might lose your balance a little, so you just lean forward into the toes. So drop it. So you inhale, exhale in this position. Then you bring your left leg back. So notice I'm bending my knee slightly. Push the left leg back as far as it can go. Pushing my knee over my foot, holding up the head, and breathing into my pelvis. Inhale and exhale. Then I bring my right foot to meet the left foot, pushing down on the heels like this. Again, if you find it very difficult to push down on the heels, that's fine. As long as you make a triangle as much as you can with the back and the legs. The aim is to get the back as straight as you can, pushing the chest down towards the mat. Imagine water being poured down the back and it's just sliding all the way down. You turn the head and you look either between your legs or look up towards your stomach. And breathe. 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 We'd hold this a bit longer, this position.
more than the other positions. Probably hold this for about 3 breaths to 7 breaths.
Inhale. Come down on your chin and knees. So the last position I was in was known as nut. Now we're going into what's called wajra, cobra. You push.
Through the hands, just like so.
Through the arms. Arching back. You're opening up your chest to the sky. Just like so, opening up the heart.
Now the hands, look, again, press down into the mat and you're spreading your fingers.
So you're
stabilizing yourself.
You draw the shoulder blades back so you can open up the chest. You point the chin towards the sky and you breathe into the chest. Nice and deep.
So now, exhale. Lower.
You're going into what's called Horus rising. So push up, just like so. Now, some folks they drop their chest all the way down and then they want to collapse and rest. Avoid doing that. Try and hover, just hover on the mat, just like this, and then relax. Pushing through. You're working the shoulders, the triceps, the forearms, the wrists, and your core. Okay? So the core being the back and the abdominals. All of them are getting the tone, then you roll back.
Stretch. You can step in a little bit so you can push back on the heels. Back into nut the sky. Inhale, exhale. Inhale and exhale.
Remember, so you may find it difficult pushing on the heels, and the heels only come up just a little bit. That's okay. One way of easing that tension from the hamstrings, if they're very tight, is to alternate the stretch like this. By stepping. So you alternate a few times and then you push again down on the heels. Now the next movement is that you're gonna come back up into a leg stretch. You bring the knee into the chest, fold the foot directly in between the hands, like so. Okay, and then again, you breathe into the pelvis. So when you're doing that movement, arch the back, crunch the abs. It's working your abdominals here. Bring the knee to the chest, fold the foot between the hands, just like so. Working up the sweat here. So, inhale, exhale, breathing into your pelvis, stretching. Now you bring the left foot to meet the right foot. Stretch out the legs. Remember to lean slightly forward onto the toes, stretching the hamstring, pushing the buttocks as high up towards the sky as you can.
Pulling the head towards the knees.
Again, it's okay if you touch just to the top of the knees, salsa, or the bottom of the knees, or down into the ankles, like so, to hold that stretch. Just go as far as you can. You breathe. Breathe. This is known as standing nut. Now when you're coming up, again you're making an elliptic line. So you're
coming up, creating that pyramid, that wooden pyramid, and so with the hands. Roll back, then the hands turn into a ball, so you bring the thumbs together, lean back. And forward. Now, when you're leaning back, now, when you're leaning back, you can breathe in this position. Inhale, exhale, coming all the way down. You're going to do the other side. So you've just done one side of the body. We're working with Ma'at, so that means that we use balance, equilibrium, and all that we do. So in stretches, you'll do both sides of the body. You wouldn't do one side, you'd do both to keep the body in balance. So we're doing the right leg going over the back, you're pushing the knee forward. So breathe into the pelvis, inhale. Exhale. Then you bring the left foot back to meet. And remember, you're pushing back on the heels. Again, if you find it very difficult to bring the heels down onto the mat, again, you can just do those little steps, pushing, stretching, and then push down. So this is not the sky. It represents, symbolically, Nut is the mother of Ra, and giving birth to Ra at dawn and swallowing Ra, or covering Ra at night. Now we're going to go down into Cobra. Wajet, notice my shape, my body shape. The knee is down and the chin is down, and I'm hovering over the mat into Cobra, just like so. Now to open up the chest to the sky and draw the shoulder blades in. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Also notice that my elbows are not locked, like straight. They're slightly bent. This has enabled me to lever my body backwards, just like so. Not putting too much strain on the shoulders. Then I lower, hover, push up. Porous rising, often known as the plank. And to strengthen the body, to condition the body, you can hold this for 10 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute, to condition the body. And then we lean back. Step in, back into Nut, the sky. Inhale, now you're going to bring the left knee into the chest, fold the foot out between the hands. We're rising up. Inhale, breathe. Right foot to meet the left foot. Again, stretch, drop the hip. Again, you may find that you're leaning back, lean forward onto the toes. Breathe. Rise all the way. Breathe. remember the hands are in a pyramid position. Boom. Finishing off, the hands coming to back into a prayer position, like so. Then they open up. This position is known as Varu or Ha, which means on high. You're spreading the fingers, flexing the fingers. Hands are face out. Then you inhale, you bring the left hand across the chest and then the right over the left. And exhale. This position is known as Asa or Saru or Cyrus. What you're doing is you're replenishing yourself. You're sending the energy that you've generated back into the body. Now you rise up on your toes, so, and we go into offset the front like this. Outstretch the arms, stay on the toes, and lower all the way down. Stay balanced. All set, the throne, just once. And then, you just lie back into mummy position. That's it.